Hi folks, Will from MinIO here with a how-to on downloading objects from MinIO using .NET. And in this video, we're going to be using .NET version 6, and we're going to be connecting out to play.min.io, which is our online sandbox for anybody who wants to try out the MinIO platform. And we're going to be doing all of this out of Visual Studio 2022, and I'm running Visual Studio 2022 here on my Mac. And I have a few different things to show you. All of this is going to happen out of the GetObjectAsync method, and I'm going to show you the difference on how to call that method, whether you want to write to a file or to a stream. And then I'm also going to review StatObjectAsync as a gate before you actually run the GetObjectAsync method to just make sure that your actual object is there before you try to download it. Let's take a look at that code. So here we've got our usual program with this very simple main method. The main method is just connecting out to play.min.io, and it's calling the run method here. I've also used the main method to handle any exceptions so that my run method is not cluttered up with a bunch of exception code as well. So let's go ahead and take a look at what we're going to be doing here. I'm connecting out to our .NET demo bucket, and I'm pulling down an object named helloworld.txt that I've already uploaded to this demo bucket. So the first thing I want to do is I want to make sure that the object exists before I try to get it. And I'm going to do this with the stat object async and the stat object args argument that goes to the stat object async method. This is really just to confirm that the object is there. If the object isn't there, this will throw an exception that will stop the execution. But in this case, since I know the object is there, it's going to go ahead and move forward, and then I can actually pull down my input stream. And what I'm going to do is I'm going to simply pull down the object from the bucket, and then I'm going to write that object, since it's just text, I'm going to write it out to my console. Now, in an actual production environment, there are any number of different things I might want to do with this stream. I may need to hand it off to another application. For instance, if I was pulling this down as an image, maybe I use that image in a photo editing tool or something like that that I've automated behind the scenes. It really does highly depend on what you're actually going to do with the object. In this case, I'm just writing it out to my console. So let's go ahead and run this, and you'll see that I call the getObjectAsync there with the getObjectArgs. And if I run this .NET run, what I get out is a whole bunch of text. Now, this text is actually all from a website called Bob Ross Lorem Ipsum. And that's just because I wanted to have something that was a little more interesting than just some vague lorem ipsum code. So when I ran that .NET run, there's some text that popped out of that for me. So what can I do with this? Well, there's a couple of other arguments I might want to show you here. Let me go ahead and show you this with offset and length. And this allows you to just pull a certain piece of your actual stream. I don't have to print out the entire stream. I just want a certain part of this, which I will then write out. I'm going to grab from 1002, I'm going to grab about 60 bytes worth. And what this is going to do for me when I save this and run this again, it's going to give me just one of the quotes in there. So it's going to basically come back and say, hey, you just practice and find out which way works best for you, which I think encompasses all of coding at the end of the day. But that allows us to download a stream. Instead of sending it to a stream, let's send it to a file. Now, of course, I could take my stream that I've just pulled here and write it to a file using a file stream writer or something like that. But there is a much easier way. And the way I'm going to do this is I'm going to call with file. And with file takes a file name, and it allows me to write this out. So I'm going to give it the file name of /temp download. We'll call it practice.txt because it's just going to be this one value. And once we've got that in there, we're going to save it, and we're going to run this one more time. And no output, that's okay. I'm going to do a more on temp dl practice, and there it is. Just the single quote that's popping out there for me. So that way I can just take part of the stream. I could also take the entire stream if I wanted to and just write it out to a file very simply. So that allows me to use this getObjectAsync to download either a file or a stream. The difference, it's all in how you set up your getObjectArgs variable. I hope you've enjoyed this little how-to on how to download an object from MinIO. If you'd like to reach out to us, you can use any of the methods you see here on the screen, or you can connect with us on minio.slack.com for an interactive conversation. You can also leave a comment right here on the video. We'll see you for the next one.